Question 320, Shikhar Venkatan.
28, sir.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, sir. I want to know from the minister through you, sir. Sir, over the years, the area of cultivable agriculture land is gradually declined, and the existing lands are also diverted to non-agriculture purposes. This has resulted in reduction in agriculture land, lesser production, and loss of employment opportunity in the agriculture sector. Whether the government have taken any steps to prevent the diversion of agriculture land for non-agricultural purposes and direction, if any issued to the state governments to monitor the situation, if so, the details thereof, sir.
Details to nahi hoga,
regarding this diversion for non-agricultural purpose, in fact, I will require separate notice, but I will reply.
That is not here, yes.
Here, there was a discussion in the same house, in August house, that we should finalize some policy for diversion of agricultural land for industrial purpose, that is non-agricultural purpose. There was a cabinet subcommittee under my chairmanship, and committee had made a recommendation, which recommendation has been approved by the cabinet and has been sent to the respective all state government. Main suggestion which has been communicated to the state government, land where one can take one or two crops should not be diverted for non-agriculture purpose, but either for sales or for industrial purpose. Lands which are essentially not cultivable, lands which are not useful for any crop, or lands which are barren land, priority should be given to these type of land to convert into non-agriculture purpose, whether it is for urbanization, where it is for industrialization, where it is for sales. So that type of communication has been sent to the all states, and I hope this appropriate action will be taken by the state government.
Second supplementary.
Whether the government have any proposal to embark upon the second green revolution to enhance the agricultural operations and also to promote more employment opportunities in the field.
The second green revolution is also, I will require a separate notice, but number of decisions has been taken.
But you are too knowledgeable, you are answering everyone.
So, there are number of schemes has been introduced in last 2 years. I would like to remind the honourable members, about 2 years back in same house, there was a lot of complaints and unhappiness expressed by many members because of the import of some of the agriculture items. And today, we are discussing how we are going to dispose of the surplus production. So the situation has been changed because there are many new decisions have been taken. That is the beginning of the green revolution. And I'm confident, even this year's season, our total production will be more than country's requirement and will be the surplus. So we have already, I'm correct.
Sri Rupchand Pal. Sri Subbarayan. Not MSM. Yes.
Sir, although in the statement it has been shown that there is a growth of 11.11% in 10 years in the number of cultivators and agricultural workers, but our common experience that the number of agricultural workers are increasing, as because the common experience of the decline in interest in direct agricultural activities as a result of cost of agriculture being high and the decline in prices of agricultural products, and the non-farm sector is growing very fast. In view of such a situation and the reports that Dr. Swaminathan Committee report and others are telling that this trend will continue in a country like India, in such a situation, may I know from the government whether the government has any comprehensive plan to use the skill of these non-farm people who have been thrown out of the agricultural sector? Thank you.
Firstly, that whatever the recommendation which was made by Dr. Swaminathan Commission, most of the recommendation has been accepted and we have started implementing this. Now the question is, the surplus resources, human resources in agriculture. One should not forget, you see, that overall country's position is such, there is too much pressure on land. Just I'd like to give a small example. In 1947, when we got the freedom, that time the total percentage of the population which was depending on the agriculture was 80%, and 80% of out of 36 crore. Today we have crossed 106 crore, and 60% of 106 crore, that means the dependence on agriculture has been practically, the growth is more than 300%, and we have seen the holding has come down. The holding, 82% farmers of this country is below 2 hectares, and out of that 60% agriculture is rain fed, where there is no assured water, and that's why it is becoming day by day uneconomic. Unless and until we reduce the population pressure on agriculture and provide some gainful employment in elsewhere section, I don't think we'll be able to resolve this basic problem. And that is the reason agriculture is important, food security is important, equally industrialization is also important, and there has to be balance in both things where we'll be able to use these surplus human resources.
Sri Ajay Chakravarti.
It is the fact that the due to the land conversion in the some states, some area of the different state, they are making the conversion the land, agricultural land, paddy land in a brickfield manufacturing area and fishery also. Due to that, the production are decreasing of the paddy and other agricultural varieties, and also the agricultural workers, they have thrown out the job. So government of India,
they are going to the brick fields.
No, they are not going to, they are not the expert of the brick field. They are the agricultural worker. So I want to know from the honorable minister whether the government has taken cognizance of this matter, and whether government is considering to give the direction and guideline to the state government to take step in order to prevent, so that the agricultural land may not be converted in the fishery or brick manufacturing field.
This particular problem was essentially noticed to the government in the one state, that is Andhra. And it is true that sizable acre of land has been converted for the aquaculture purpose. But there also we have communicated to the state government the land which is useful for taking any type of food crop should not be converted for this type of purpose. And we are not going to encourage for this purpose. It is not correct that the paddy or the rice crop production has been dropped. This last year, we have produced a record paddy, and till yesterday, our procurement of this year is also much higher than last year, so picture is quite satisfactory.
Sri Lal Singh.
सर
नेक्स्ट सेशन नेक्स्ट हाउस
सर मैं आपकी इजाजत से मंत्री साहब से जाना चाहता हूं हमारी अपनी स्टेट में सर लाखें एकड़ जमीन हमारी पड़ी है जैसे किश्तवाड़ की है डोडा की है और खासकर उधमपुर की है कठुआ की है हमारा टोटल कंडी का एरिया और पहाड़ी एरिया बैरान पड़ा है लाखों एकड़ ज़मीन हमारी ऐसे पड़ी है जिससे ना कोई प्रोडक्शन है हर बरस लोगों का लाश के सिवा कुछ नहीं होता मैं मंत्री साहब से यह कहना चाहूँगा एक तो आप जो आपका सिस्टम है ड्रिप सेट देते हो स्प्रिंकल देते हो और जो आपकी प्लानिंग है बड़ा सब स्टैंडर्ड देते हैं और इतना घटिया उसमें आता है कि वो ये इस ज़मीन को इरीगेट नहीं कर सकता मैं ये आपसे जानना चाहता हूँ कि ये जो बैरन लैंड है हमारे इलाके की इसके लिए सरकार की तरफ से कोई स्पेशल कोई ऐसा पैकेज दिया जा सकता है जिससे ये टोटल ज़मीन को इरीगेट किया जाए और लोगों को इसका फ़ायदा हो और जो भी इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स जो इक्विपमेंट इसके लिए देने पड़े वो भी उसके लिए ठीक ठाक दिए जाएं इसे मैं जानना चाहता हूँ साहब से
सिंपल बात ये है कि वन शुड नॉट फॉरगेट द एज पर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एग्रीकल्चर इज द स्टेट सब्जेक्ट सो वॉट एवर दिस टाइप ऑफ स्कीम आर इम्प्लीमेंटेड बाई द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट It is true that Government of India is providing some financial support for some of the scheme. Now, Honourable Member is complaining that material which has been supplied for the drip and sprinkler and other is not up to the mark. Government of India don't buy and supply any material. Government of India just provides subsidy to the state government, which state government should provide to the farmer. Ultimately, what type and what quality should be purchased, of whether it is drip or whether it is drip sprinkle, it is a prerogative of the farmers.
Sri Ramkripa, I asked you, called your name last one.
Sorry, I am late, sir.
You can ask anyone any question. Theek hai.
Mananiya Adhyaksh Mahoday, कि हम सब लोगों को एहसास है कि हमारी अर्थव्यवस्था बिल्कुल खेत और खलिहान पर निर्भर करती है, किसानों पर निर्भर करती है. मैं आपके माध्यम से माननीय मंत्री से यह जानना चाहता हूं सीधे तौर पर. ये बात भी सही है सर कि जितना उत्साह वर्धन किसानों को होना चाहिए वो हो नहीं रहे हैं, और जो क्षमता उनकी है उस क्षमता के अनुसार हम किसानों को उत्साहित नहीं कर पा रहे हैं, इसलिए हम उत्पादन क्षमता भी नहीं बढ़ा पा रहे हैं. यो तो ये देखा गया है कि उत्पादन क्षमता है उससे कम हमारा उत्पादन हो रहा है. माननीय मंत्री से हम ये जानना चाहेंगे सर कि बिहार जैसा पिछड़ा प्रदेश जहाँ सूखा और बाढ़ दोनों है, जिसके वजह से उनका उत्पादन क्षमता जो है वो कम हो पाता है, ऐसे राज्यों को उत्साहवर्धन करने के लिए किसानों को और इसमें संलग्न होकर अच्छी खेती करें, उसके लिए कोई विशेष योजना आपके पास है?
See, 19th May of year 2008, the Prime Minister has to call a special meeting of the Chief Ministers just to discuss this particular problem. And there, decision was taken that Government of India will provide a package of 25,000 crores, that is RKVY, mainly to bring those states whose productivity is below national average. Choice has been given to the state government. They should prepare a proposal. They should submit a proposal according to their need. It is a need base, and Government of India will provide money. So we have started implementing that scheme from last year. Often I will not be able to tell what exactly monetary support has been given to the Bihar. If there is a separate notice, definitely I will be happy to communicate all these information to honourable member.
Thank you. श्री बाला साहेब वी के पाटिल.
मैं आपके माध्यम से मंत्री जी से जानना चाहूँगा कि ये वेदर द गवर्नमेंट हैज असिस्टेंस रिस्पांसिबिलिटी फॉर टेक्नोलॉजी अपग्रेडेशन इन द लेबर ओरिएंटेड एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर. तो पहले भारत दो साल के पहले भारत सरकार ने एक रेन फेड फार्म डेवलपमेंट नेशनल डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी बनाई थी. इस माध्यम से इस टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रांसफर में कितना काम हुआ, और जो हमारे फार्म घाटे में ड्राइव लैंड के उसको नफा लाने के लिए इस टेक्नोलॉजी की कामयाबी कितनी मिली, और इसी कारण के साथ हमारा उत्पादन बढ़ने में जो जीडीपी हमारा 54% से 12% 16% है वो बढ़ने में कोई हमको मदद मिलेगी क्या?
इसी रेनफेल अथॉरिटी हैज बीन सेट अप बाय गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया टू इयर्स बैक दैट जनरली गिव गाइडलाइन टू द वेरियस स्टेट्स हाउ टू इम्प्लीमेंट द प्रोग्राम इन रेनफेल एरिया. Actually, the execution of the scheme is again are given to the state government. Rainfall Authority doesn't take the any responsibility of any implementation. Certain money has been provided. In fact, I can give the all details. It will take a lot of time. There are number of schemes. Some schemes are under the Minister of Agriculture. That is, and some schemes are under the Minister of Rural Development, like. DPAP, DDPA, yes. There are a number of other schemes also. Through these schemes, substantial monetary support has been provided to the various states. In fact, if you want the information, it will take a lot of time, but yes. I can provide this information. Okay. In fact, this is not part of question, this is a part of some other question. I got information, but
the Honourable Member can say.